I'm going to show you how to check for trademarks for your print on demand business. All right. Now, when it comes to this, keep in mind there are different classifications for each one. And the one that I'm looking for right now is classification 25025. This is for tops and t-shirts. Now, each classification is going to be different depending on the product that you're using. All right. When you're thinking about this, just think about t-shirt designs and tops and hoodies and tank tops, stuff like that. V-necks, anything with the top part, right? Okay, that's what we're focusing on in this video. Now, if you're doing like pillows or tumblers, pop sockets, okay, that is a different classification. So you would have to research that and look that up on your end. I'll show you a tool that will help you actually look for the actual trademarks themselves. But other than that, let's get into it. I keep it very simple, very easy, straight to the point. I was actually uploading designs on my end and doing some double checking with trademarks, because trademarks, they can be a little bit confusing. Copyrights can be a little bit confusing when it comes to any of this. So let's get into the video and give this video a thumbs up. Top research design vault with 700 plus research niches back here. You get new research every single week with keywords, low competition, and the link for the design inspiration. And then on top of that, you get fresh ideas for these niches to help you create an original design. Now, the goal is to help you understand what is selling so you can create your own unique top selling design for this niche or idea or concept. My goal is to help you make sales, okay? And that is very important to me, because if I do that for you, it's easier for me to create an amazing product like this right here. Now, it's only $10 a month and you can cancel at any time. You get access to all of the previous niches once you sign up to as well. And then I'll be releasing new niches every single week.
Now, this is the way that I check for trademarks personally myself. There's a few different ways I check for trademarks, all right? So there is TM Hum, and then I use the Merchant Farmer Chrome extension, okay? There's several different ways that you can do this, right? You can actually go onto the actual USPTO website into this too as well. There's a few different ways that this can be done, right? So keep in mind, but as I'm doing this, as I'm looking at the designs and make double checking everything, this is one thing that we have to do for our print on demand business, because obviously we don't want to break any rules. So I checked all these right here. You're going to see, let me show you an example. So phrases you can upload to 10 at a time. And then I just went ahead and hit search, and then it goes in and searches them. Now you can do the results of 10, 25, 50, or 100. I do just come over here to just leave it as is. Status, I go live. Now the type, I do a text. So you can do all, it's up to you. You want to do all, you can, it'll show you all the live designs right here. You got 4 pages to go through, and then you can adjust it here if you wanted to. And then everything would be on one page, right? So let's go ahead and see. What I like to do too is go over by the type and just do text. Okay, let me see if it's live. Now, usually with single words, guys. Now, this can be a little bit confusing. I know that if you're from a different country or just you're not in the US, trademarks are, first things first, are just sometimes are too much, right? Like, for reals, that's trademark. And yes, that is trademarked. So you can't upload the design. I look for 2 or more keywords together. So like these single ones, it's unless it's like a Nike or something like that, then you got to be very careful. Now, if you go down, you're seeing all this. Look at, here's 2 keywords. This is what I mean. Now you click on the serial number right here. It's going to bring us over to the USPTO website itself. Now we're going to come over here. Look at the status. You see the status. It says it's seen that it's live. Sometimes you'll see this will be like, it'll be like a dead trademark. So it'll be like a crossed out, it'll be red. So do nothing. Then if you come over here, notice the registration, and then you'll see like their registration certificate. Usually like when it gets to this part right here, when you see that most likely it's live, right? They got their certificate. Okay. So here's a breakdown. But if you see it like drawing application, and if you see it like at this part right here, this is a whole process that it has to go through, right? If you see it just at this part right here, okay, it's in the process of doing it and it's not live. So you can technically still upload the design, but you have to be careful because you want to go back and double check that it's when your design's live, making hundreds and hundreds of dollars, right? And this can happen. This has happened to, I know a few people that's happened to, and I want to say it's happened to me before, where you upload a design and then the trademark's not even in the drawing or the application process. And then a few layers later, it's, oh, what up? That's trademark. Now it's live. My design got taken down. And that was like one of my top sellers. It was making a lot of money. You won't have, there's nothing you can do because went ahead and no trademark it. Now, should you have done it? That's up to you. If you're making a good amount of money for it and you plan on starting your own brand or getting behind it and stuff like that, and it's up to you. Now, when I'm looking at this, it's, you could do it also just with your actual, your artwork and stuff like that. You can do that too as well. Now, you just have something else that you have to keep in mind. So there's rules against AI-created designs, and there's rules against stuff like that. And like a lot of the drawings and the artwork that I personally use, is 80% of it, it's all hand-drawn. Okay, it's hand-drawn, and then the colors filled in and stuff like that. Okay, so if I come over here, let's go back over here. I don't want to go too far off with this. We're looking at this, but then you have to come over here and look at the goods and services. One thing, you're right here, depending what you're uploading to, I upload to a lot of t-shirts. You can see that the classification is 025 primary class, right? But look right here, it's only for footwear. Usually right here, it'll be like tops or shirts, right? When it's like that, then you cannot do that. But right now, it's in the clear. You're in the clear because you're just double checking. It's taking it to that next level too. We're looking at that, and we did a whole list of different phrases and a design. After you do that, you check all this, everything looks clear. Come over here to design, check over here, making sure everything's good too, right? You're just clicking on some of the stuff you want to look, you can see. But usually just the text, right? What we're looking for is just that text, because the text is usually what's in the, I'm not taking a design from somebody or like this graphic from nobody, right? I'm actually just creating the design. But now if you have a like a design and you want to go double check and make sure, you can obviously, you can see like the different designs. I'm not taking from none of that. So you just, what we're looking for is mainly the text part. That's what I do personally. That's what I do. Now let's say, okay, these are all good. Those are good. We're clear. Let's go move on to the next one. And you're going to see how I just neon batters, right? And that word neon, we want to be careful with that word, right? So I'll probably take this actual design out. I'm looking at, and so I'm double checking all my designs. I'm just going through the whole process and seeing what, so scoop it, smash it. And that's what I'm doing. So yeah, that's how I made that whole list, is going down that whole thing. Now, so for this example, let's say we're good with these. We're done. We're going to go ahead and hit search again. We'll do the same exact thing live and then go to the text. We're looking, we're in the good. Remember, just single keywords, I really don't pay attention to, unless we're like we're not doing Nike. Like I told you, we're not doing Nike. And then you can, if you want to just look at everything else, if you want to do that, you can definitely do that. But usually anything with like, we're looking for the text. That's all we're looking for. Okay. So when I look for that, look at that, look at all this stuff and look at all this information, that's what I'm looking for. But just going through the whole process of double checking everything. And remember, the business is probably like one of the most tedious. It can be confusing. I can see why people get confused with this part. And if you want to take it a step further, you can just do a search on Google to make sure that you're not getting from a movie or anything like that. Okay. It's important that you understand this part of the business, because you have to, if especially if you just plan on doing this long term. This is definitely, like I said, it can be tedious and take a bit of time, but someone has to do it. You have to do it. And I personally have been doing it over the years, double checking myself on my end. Like I have designers, I have team members that have been creating designs with me for the last 8 years. And just because I have other stuff that I'm busy with. And then I just always, I outsource this part of it because it makes things so much easier and it helps you get more work done. And the more work you get done, the more money you make. That's the whole process behind this. But checking for trademarks, I still do it on my end just to double check everything. Just keep that in mind. It's just tmhunt.com. And then, or you can even just go to the over to the USPTO website and do that too as well. And then the Chrome extension I'm talking about is Merch Informer or Trademark Check, right? And this comes these little tabs up here. So MI Trademark Check, this is basically for like tops and stuff. And if you check that, you can see if it pops up anything, it'll pop up like that. And you can click on it, then it'll bring you straight over to the USPTO website. But it has the pop sockets are different from t-shirts, tote bags, and pillows, and then tumblers. So there's a few different ways. So you have to make sure that you're, when you're checking for any of this, like you're looking for the right classification. So when you're looking for, that's why when I was using TM Hunt, let me show you team. When I using TM Hunt, you're going to see that with TM Hunt, like it's, we're using, this is checking for clothing trademarks. Okay. So keep that in mind when you're looking at any of this stuff. We're looking, we're using TM Hunt, it's looking for the clothing trademark. So that's helps us out a bit. But if you want to take it a step further, you can come over here and use the Merchant Former Trademark Checker. It's a Chrome extension plugin, very simple, very easy. I'm not even sure why the reviews are so low. Okay. 3.5. There's over 30,000 users. It works. Okay. There's an, I'm just like, if you see a design or if you're looking for something, you think it's a cool design, you want to create your own, you can definitely do that. But you just like literally hit the trademark check and it'll tell you if it's trademarked or not. So super teacher, like on that phrase, there's nothing. You're good. You're clean. This design is in the clear to create. Okay. Something, if you want to create something similar to this or whatever your goal is with this. Now here's an example. So drip season, you see this right here. As I'm going through the trademark checking part, I come down here to 025 on USPTO. But I used a TM Hunt and I found that this one seems to be live. This is a two-letter word. trademark, usually stuff like this, Amazon is pretty strict on. I'm talking about when I'm uploading to Amazon Merch on Demand too as well, but it pretty much, I think it applies to any print on demand website when it comes to this right here. If we come over here, you see drip season, right? And then we come over here, look at 25025 clothing, hooded sweatshirts and tops as clothing. So like me personally, that's what I would stay away from. Sometimes it'll say t-shirts, but tops as clothing, I take that as being trademarked. So I feel like if they're going to send you something like, or tell you if you're going to get a rejection, that's where it's going to come from. So this design right here, this would be a no for me. It's already created. Sometimes this is what happens when you're creating a lot of designs, right? Some of this stuff gets slipped through the cracks, just the cracks of the actual process of checking everything. And there's nothing wrong with that. Okay, this is like part of the game. This right here is a no, but like this one thing is just, you try to get it before you're actually creating the design because you don't want that to happen. But when you're looking at this stuff and the design's being created and you're double checking everything, it's, damn, isn't it a waste of time? Yes, it is a waste of time. This is part of the business. This is a part of the game. So we're all human. We're not robots or nothing like that. We make mistakes and that's totally understandable. So this design is trademarked and I would not upload this design because of this. Doesn't mean I won't upload the graphic and switch this around, put something else here. Just this drip season, I'm staying away from drip season. And if you want low competition niche research done for you, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.